Welcome to Cost Accounting. This video will cover multiple product or multi-product CVP, Cost Volume Profit Analysis. Product profitability can be measured many different ways. The most efficient and the most accurate way to measure is using contribution margin. Ultimately, the goal is to generate the largest profit of most companies. If customers walk in the door and say they want to buy one unit of product, and they really don't care which one, the company should focus its profitability on the per unit profitability. In other words, push the product with the higher contribution margin per unit. Notice that if a customer desires to purchase a unit, we should focus the contribution margin on a per unit amount. If customers prefer to spend a fixed sum of money and they really don't care which products they buy, the company should focus on the sales dollar, and out of every sales dollar, which product is the most profitable. In other words, push the product with the higher contribution margin ratio, and we know the ratio, its denominator, is the sales dollar. It's the highest profit out of each sales dollar that a company can generate. Sales mix is a new concept for many of you. This is the relative proportion in which a company's products are sold. If you go to McDonald's and pay attention to the types of products each of the customers are buying, you'll find that more people purchase soft drinks than those who may purchase, say, a Big Mac. So if the company sat down and determined the proportion of each of its products, it may sell one Big Mac to every two orders of fries, to every one cup of coffee, to every four soft drinks. Companies need to have a good handle on their sales mix. This helps them predict profits for the future, and it also helps them in ordering supplies and materials so that they have enough on hand. Based on the premise that different products have different selling prices, cost structures, and contribution margins is why sales mix is important. There are two ways to express it. Here is an example of buckets and pails. The first way to express sales mix is based on units, or the unit sales mix. So this company sells 2,000 buckets for every 8,000 pails. Once we reduce this to lowest terms, this tells us that for every bucket a company sells, it will sell 4 pails. When we reduce to lowest terms, we cannot have any decimals or fractions, so these need to be whole numbers. The second way to express sales mix is based on sales revenue. In this case, 4,000 of revenue for buckets and 6,000 for pails. Reducing this to lowest terms, for every $2 we generate selling buckets, the company generates $3 selling pails. We will use the concept of sales mix in looking at cost volume profit analysis with multiple products. There are two approaches. The first one is called the weighted average approach, often known as the contribution approach. It's based on the weighted average contribution margin for all products combined. The bundle approach is based on the unit contribution margins of each product, which are weighted by the sales mix. We can use either of these methods to calculate break-even in units or sales revenue, or either of those at a target profit level. Let's begin with the weighted average approach, break-even in units. The steps are listed here. We first calculate the weighted average contribution margin per unit. We use the weighted average per unit contribution margin per unit amount in the profit equation to calculate the break-even point in units. This is the break-even point for all products. When we multiply the sales mix proportion by the unit break-even point for each product, that will give us the number of units for each respective product. We always have to round up to the next full unit. If we round down, the company may incur a loss. Note that we are calculating units here. So we use the weighted average contribution margin per unit. We use the unit sales mix. So these units are both based on units when we're calculating a break-even or target profit in units. Let's look at the weighted average break-even in revenue dollars. We first calculate the weighted average contribution margin ratio. Again, we know that a ratio, in calculating it, the denominator is revenue dollars. Total contribution margin divided by total sales revenue. We use the contribution margin ratio in the profit equation, and this will help us calculate the break-even point for all products in sales revenue. Then we calculate the revenue sales mix and multiply the sales mix proportion by the revenue break-even point, and this will give us break-even for each individual product. Note again that because we're using the ratio and the revenue sales mix, both of these are based on revenue, this will help us calculate revenue dollars. Both of these items are based on sales revenue. Let's take an example. We are going to determine how many units of each product the company must sell to break even. Even if the problem would ask you how many donuts should the company sell, we still have to begin with the weighted average approach. Our two products, donuts and bagels, are added together to give us totals. And it's this total column that we use to determine a weighted average contribution margin per unit. In doing this, we take the total contribution margin, $98.90, and because we're calculating an amount based on units, our denominator is the total 10,000 units, or almost 99 cents per unit. We then plug this into the profit equation. And so here's our profit equation that we've reduced or factored out the X so that we have the contribution margin in the parentheses. We plug in the 0.989 for contribution margin. Total fixed costs are subtracted, and this gives us the break-even in units for both products. We have to consider the unit sales mix to figure out of the 5,511 units, how many are donuts and how many are bagels. So our unit sales mix, 4,500 to 5,500, is 9 to 11. The company sells 9 donuts for every 11 bagels. If we were to break this 5,510.617 break-even point up into proportional amounts, there would be 20 of those, 9 plus 11. So 9 and 11 portions total up to 20. Donuts are 9 twentieths of this total, and bagels are 11 twentieths. So if we multiply these fractions, we get 2,480 donuts and 3,031 bagels. Note that we rounded up. If we round down, we may cause the company to experience a loss. In revenue dollars, again, because the company has multiple products, we use the amounts in the total column. We first calculate the weighted average contribution margin ratio because we're trying to calculate revenue dollars. This gives us $98.90 over the $17,750 of revenue, or just short of 56%. The revenue sales mix is based on the total revenue of each of the two products, $6,750 to $11,000. Reducing this to lowest terms, again, no fractions or decimals, this tells us that for every $27 generated from the sale of donuts, the company generates $44 from the sale of bagels. We plug in the weighted average contribution margin ratio into the profit equation, subtract the total fixed cost, and solve. And this tells us for the entire company, if they generate $9,781 and about 35 cents, they will break even. We need to know how much of this total revenue is for each of the products. So looking back at the revenue sales mix, we see that we need 27 portions and 44 portions, or a total, if we add these together, of 71. So 27 over 71 of that $9,781. Our donuts will generate $3,720 of revenue, and bagels, 44 over 71 times the total revenue break-even, will generate $6,062 for bagels. The bundle approach, we must first determine the unit contribution margin for each product. Then we determine the unit sales mix. The profit equation is a little more complicated. We need to consider each product separately in the profit equation. It will look somewhat like this, where CM is contribution margin, in this case the contribution margin of product 1, times the sales mix of product 1, and then the contribution margin of product 2 times the sales mix of product 2. And if we had 3 products, we'd then have the contribution margin of product 3 times the sales mix of product 3. In all cases, we subtract the total fixed cost to give us profit. This problem here, this equation, assumes we have 2 products, but companies often have tens of thousands of products. The answer that we generate once we calculate is a bundle amount. It tells us how many bundles we have to sell. We multiply the sales mix, which is a whole number for each product, separately by the bundle amount. If we want to determine break-even in sales dollars, once we get the break-even in units, we multiply the break-even units by the selling price per unit. Let's look at a bundle approach example. So this company sells 2 varieties of tacos, beef and pork. The sales mix in units, the company sells 3 beef for every 5 pork tacos. So we need to determine the break-even point in units of each product. In setting up the profit equation, we need the contribution margins per unit of each product. For beef, we have $5.50 minus $3.08, or $2.42. And for pork, $4 minus the $2.08. These 2 amounts will be used in the profit equation, along with our sales mix of 3 to 5 units. So for beef, $2.42. We don't know the number of units yet. That's what we're trying to calculate. And the sales mix is 3 to 5, so we have our 3 here. To that, we're going to add it to the contribution margin per unit for pork times the sales mix of 5 in each bundle, and 3 of these in each bundle. Subtract the total fixed cost. We have to add these 2 amounts together. 12,000 plus 11,200 gives us 23,200. Our answer tells us that we have to sell just over 1,376 bundles. Before you round, wait till we break this 1,376 amount down into the individual products, beef and pork. For beef, We multiply the 1,376 bundles times the number of beef tacos in each bundle. That gives us 4,129 beef tacos. Pork, we use the 5 from the unit sales mix. In order to break even, we must sell 6,881 pork tacos, 4,129 beef tacos. To get sales mix, or to get the break even in revenue dollars, we multiply the 4,122 beef tacos by the $5.50, and then we multiply the 6,881 pork tacos times the $4 selling price. This concludes the multiple product CVP analysis. Thanks for stopping by, and come back again.